It was just over 10 years ago. I was sitting in the hospital room with my wife and our new baby daughter. And we were just about to welcome guests into that room to meet this new girl, this new member of our family for the first time. And my wife and I made a decision. I pulled a piece of paper out of my bag. I quickly scribbled on a little note, hung it up beside her crib. And that little note was received with much amusement as well as positivity from the nursing staff on the floor at the time, and a little bit less positivity from the friends and family who had visited. You see, it just said a couple of simple words. Please don't share me on Facebook. Hi, I'm Kelly. I'm a father of six, I'm a full-time software developer at Rescue Time, and I'm a dean at Sigma University. On this channel, I talk about productivity tips so that you can be more efficient at work, so you can spend less time there and more time with your family and on the things that you love. Quite a few of you have asked me, if I have six children, why am I not putting them in my YouTube videos? Why are they on camera? I mean, everybody loves to see children. They do all sorts of amusing things, and it's just a blast to watch, especially seeing parents interact with their children. Well, it goes back to that decision that we made 10 years ago. We decided we weren't going to be putting our children on the internet, and we were going to be actively asking those around us to do the same and to respect our wishes. Now, believe it or not, this was a pretty hard decision to make. I mean, everyone loves to share their children with others. I mean, you know the trope, you know, someone pulls out a wallet or a photo album or something like, oh, come look at these children, aren't they so cute? Yeah, I love to do the same thing. I love to share the antics that my children are up to and all these cute positions that they fall asleep in with friends and family. But we decided we wanted to keep that for sharing with our friends and family and not sharing with just the general public or people we don't know. You see, we chose to respect our children's privacy. Okay, let me take a step back there. This is a choice that we made. Yolanda and I thought that this was the right choice for us. That doesn't mean it is the right choice for everyone. So everything I'm going to say now, take it with a grain of salt. Just evaluate it based on your own standards and where you're at to see if it is the right choice for you. But as I said, we made this decision because we felt it was important to allow our children to make this decision for their own whenever they enter their mid to later teenage years and they're able to understand the consequences of their actions. They will be able to make this decision of if they want to put their own self out there. Now, sure, I mean, this hasn't been perfect and we haven't been absolutely rigid about this. There are pictures of our children out on the internet. If we're at a social gathering and someone takes a picture and they share it on Facebook, sure, our children may end up on there accidentally. What we are doing is we are actively trying to solicit people not to just isolate our children and push them out there to share with the entire world. It's more for isolated events or situations where it's kind of beyond our control and we don't want to step in and infringe on fun that's happening with other people. And that's been a great general purpose policy, but what I want to talk about today is why our children are not showing up in my YouTube videos in particular, and why I am actively making a choice that they don't at this point in time. Once again, we may end up reevaluating this in the future and figuring out that this isn't the right decision, that times have changed and we need to change and make adjustments as well, but as of right now, they won't be in my videos at all. And I want to share with you why that is. It basically comes down to one key point. We don't want to normalize the act of putting your life on camera and sharing it with the world. Now, this is by no means a popular channel. I'm not getting millions or hundreds of thousands or even tens of thousands of views on any of my videos. Yet, I'd love it if you could help me reach that point, but as of right now, I'm only getting a couple of dozen views per video. But even so, my children are watching me film these videos and they know that I'm releasing them every single week and knowing that I am putting myself out there and sharing a part of who I am with you guys. I don't want them to grow up doing the same for themselves. I don't want to build habits in them now of them recording themselves in front of the camera or even me interacting with them in front of the camera and putting them out there for the whole world to see. I don't want to build those habits into them now. I want them to enter adulthood and make this decision for themselves. Should they put themselves out there or shouldn't they? I don't want them to reach that point and then just assume that's what they have to do, because it isn't and it shouldn't be what anyone has to do. While I think it is great that people put themselves out there and share themselves with the world, because we need that inspiration. We need to see other people that we can look up to and say, hey, you know, I love this about that person and I want to be like this person in that way. That is by far, or at least should be by far, the minority of people. I think most of us should live a life where we are keeping most of our lives to ourselves and not just putting out there for everyone to see. Because I know too many families, and I have seen too many celebrity families make this mistake. The parent has put themselves out there. Their entire life is an open book where they videotape or blog or take pictures of every single moment of their day, including their children throughout that day. And then what happens when the children become teenagers or enter adulthood? They just end up doing the same thing, but it wasn't an active decision on their part. It was just them repeating the behaviors of their parent, repeating the habits that have been instilled in them. And like I said, I don't think that's a behavior that we should get into or should encourage in one another. I think that is something that needs to be an independent choice. Making ourselves public should be a decision left up to the individual, not something that we instill in the children from a young age. Anyway, so that's my little bit of a soapbox. I hope it didn't seem like too much of a soapbox because this is just where we're at. Like I said, I think this is a decision that every family needs to make individually. And so I hope you've taken time to consider if you have children and yeah. And so just let me know what your thoughts are on the subject. I guess for those of you new here, this was not a normal video. Usually I do talk about more relating to productivity, but my whole shtick, the reason I'm here, that sounds terrible. The reason I'm here is because I want to help you all be more productive so that you can spend more time with your family and doing the things you love, which is kind of what my next video is going to be about, a new project I'm undertaking and I'm able to undertake because I work more productively and try to work more efficiently. Try. Bye. As well as much positivity from the hotel staff. Hi, I'm Kelly. I'm a full-time... Father first. Bye. Oh, yeah.